Cesium-137 is a radioactive isotope with a half-life of 30.4 years, and it's a gamma-ray emitter. So gamma-ray emission is bad for biological organisms because it causes cellular and DNA damage. This picture right here shows a radioactive reading of 3.4 microsieverts per hour that IAC recorded in Fukushima, right outside the exclusion zone. Now, a microsievert is an assessment for the radiological risk on biological organisms. So one sievert is a 5.5% risk of developing cancer over your lifetime. So while this reading seems small, if you live there for your entire life, you're increasing your risk slowly but surely as compounding. So why can't the radioactive cesium-137 be removed from the soil easily? And so our studies actually looked at how cesium gets trapped inside the clay interlayers. And so through XRD analysis, we were able to show that cesium actually decreases the interlayers of vermiculite clays from 3 angstroms to 1 angstrom, which is really bad because now it can't be removed through traditional remediation strategies. So, through an exhaustive literature review, we finally came upon a molecule called the Tetrachis-4-fluorophenylborate sodium salt dihydrate. We're going to call it TFPB. TFPB is actually selective and attractive towards cesium, and so it opened up a window of remediation possibilities. So while in Fukushima, we actually collected contaminated soil, we isolated the clay from the bulk soil and treated it with TFPB and magnesium nitrate. We have to have the magnesium nitrate so that when cesium comes off with the TFPB, something is there to replace the charge imbalance. Without that, the experiment won't work. We actually found that with TFPB and magnesium nitrate, we had a successful removal of 48 to 63% of radioactive cesium, which was astounding for us. Because this way, the waste up here can be dramatically reduced. We were able to highly concentrate the cesium-137, where it can be removed and stored much easier. This was the most successful remediation strategy in Fukushima so far that has not been proposed yet. And we're hoping that these results can be used to get people where they can move back, they can restore their farmland, and also hopefully be used to scale up so we can actually put this in a mass production scale where we can clean the entire Fukushima prefecture, or at least farmland. And above that, we hope that this method can be further developed so that we can also help future new